You haven't got a letterbox.
I know. That's because I never get any letters.
Well, you've got one today.
Oh.
Have you got a chisel?
I'll go and get one.
Hurry up, you lazy bastard!
Sorry, I was as quick as I could be.
Going on. Let's have a look. Give me the binoculars.
It's all right. I can see perfectly well what's happening. Thank you very much.
My turn.
All right, you can have them. He's two doors away. Pass me a sandwich, will you?
All right.
Look from the inside.
It's good from here.
Right. Okay, then. Good morning.
Wait a minute. This isn't for me. It's for number 166 next door. You see? I told you I never got any letters.
Yes. Yes, you're right. Sorry.
Here you are.
There he is. What'd you do that for?
Well, I'm a policeman, aren't I? Did I get him?
Well?
Well?
What do you want?
The usual things. Peace. Happiness.
And you got me off the lava tree to tell me this?
I didn't get you off the lavatory.
Well, somebody got me off the lavatory.
Were you stuck?
What?
I've got a letter for you.
Who broke my bloody bell?
Another day. Ha. Morning, June. I wonder if the post's arrived yet.
Ah, the sound of music. My most favourite film of all time.
If you ask me, it's a stupid idea.
Well, then I'm not very likely to ask you then, am I, June?
And who's ever heard of a film being shown at 9 o'clock on a Monday morning?
Well, I have.
Who's going to want to come and see it at that time in the morning, Terry?
June, have you ever heard of a thing called commuters? And have you ever heard of a thing called business enterprise? And have you ever heard of a thing called anything, June? No. No, you haven't, have you? But I have. That's what this country needs if there were more people in this country like me. If everybody in this country was me... You'd have a pretty weird telephone directory, wouldn't you?
Tea?
Well, what do you think?
I think it's a stupid idea.
All right, well, I'll have some coffee then.
Put my curry powder.
What is the matter with you this morning, Joan? Sorry, June.
It's the stupid getting up early business. I mean, what's the point? Nobody's going to come. They're all too busy doing jobs. Absolutely nobody is going to want to come and see The Sound of Music if you show it at 9 o'clock this morning.
Do you really think so?
Right. A 9 o'clock showing. How enterprising. That's just the ticket for shift workers like me that finished work at 8:30.
Breakfast, dear.
Oh, thank you, Monica. Hello, breakfast.
I hope you haven't double parked.
No, dear.
What are you going to do with yourself today, my darling?
I'm going to see the 9 o'clock showing of The Sound of Music.
A 9 o'clock showing? How enterprising.
Sweetheart, I think breakfast is escaping.
He's been restless all morning. I think he wants to go out. Do you want to go for a wee-wee, breakfast?
It's a funny name for a lobster.
Gentlemen.
Good morning, Chief.
Correct. This morning, I found this on my front doorstep.
It looks like a police bullet, Chief.
I know it. Does it?
This bullet was used to immobilize my front doorbell.
However, I'm attaching absolutely no importance to it. It's just one of these things. Pay attention, gentlemen. This is a naked woman. I have reason to believe that a motion picture film using images such as these is in our town. This is photography. Hard photography, and I will not...
Pornography, Chief.
Thank you, Sergeant. Smart aleck bastard. In our time, I want this film behind bars. I want the purveyors of this film behind bars. I want anyone who's seen this film or contemplated going to see this film behind bars. And that, gentlemen, is your job.
We know, Chief. You told us all this yesterday.
Did I? Oh, well, there you go, then.
All right.
Actually, I'm going your way, my darling, so I may as well walk with you. On second thoughts, it might be quicker the long way around.
Right, I'll see you there, June. And June, don't be late. You're doing. This is private property.
I've come to see the film.
Oh, I was wrong, darling. I do apologize.
Shut up, June. What film?
The Sound of Music.
Oh, it's off.
What do you mean?
We've lost the film.
Well, what's that then?
Ah, there it is! We found the film, June!
Didn't know we lost it, dear.
Shut up! Bloody hell. Bloody hell. Bloody hell. Bloody hell. Bloody hell. Bloody hell.
Be open in just a minute and then you'll be able to buy your ticket and some cigarettes. Some chewing gum. Some Smarties.
It's turned out nice again, hasn't it?
I've got to clean the carpet when I get home. Oh.
Thank you, Jim. Righty-ho, then. Well, if you're ready, I'll open the doors, then, shall I?
OK, love.
First in the queue.
Yeah?
So how can it be full?
What do you mean, full?
Look. House full.
Oh, sorry, yeah. It's the wrong notice again. Stupid me.
Yeah, this looks like a cinema, all right.
Hey, cinemas show films.
Oh, the penny snap. Let's go!
Now then, what's your game, Sonny?
Well, I was just trying to save this film.
I bet you were. I bet you were, you dirty bastard.
Oh, I get it. Dirty bastard, dirty film. Right.
Now then, what's your name?
Nigel.
Not you, Nigel. You.
Mr. Bean.
It's a funny name for a lobster.
Sarge. Sarge, he's not a lobster, Sarge.
I know. I'm just trying to disorientate him.
Don't do that. You'll get him confused.
That's the whole point. That's what I'm trying to do.
Oh, I get it. There, that's confused him.
Now, get up. And that is just a warning.
A warning about what exactly?
A warning about... Tell him, Nigel.
That is just a warning about what it's like to get smashed in the face, Sonny.
Don't you forget it.
What?
This.
Now then, tell us about this film.
Well... It starts off with these nuns.
Yes, yes, yes. We know it's dirty, but where is it?
I don't know.
Don't mess us about.
Put me down.
Ah. Oh, no. Another suicide. You must be more careful, Nigel. Let's stick him down that manhole. Right, up on the roof.
Well, the film's all fixed and ready to roll, June. What a pity I inadvertently gave Felix the projectionist the day off today. I'll have to show it myself. Have you been to the toilet recently, June?
Yes, dear. Why? Why?
Was this a friendly interest? Well, 9 o'clock. I'd better show the film.
But, Terry, no one's bought a ticket. There's nobody to show it to.
Yes, yes, I know that, June. But I thought I'd better just check it, you know. Now, you better stay in here and not go out at all in case of late arrivals, see? And seeing as how it's a special day today, June, you can eat as many sweets as you want.
You're right, Sarge. We'll have to use the ladder.
OK. All right, then you go first.
One for the stalls, please. What have you got?
I've got half a Mars bar somewhere.
I don't think I'll bother, thank you. Is that the way out?
Yes, I suppose so.
It's locked.
Thank you.
Yes. It's a dirty movie, all right. He's digging his own nest.
Right, then. Shall we go down and nab him, Sergeant?
No, no. Let's let him see the whole film through, then the sentence will be more severe.
Good idea.
My turn first.
Ready? Super. Since I draw. Oh.
Leaves and notices and oh look, some nuns. We're 16 going on six. Hello, miss. I'm an orphan. Would you like to enter me for a singing competition? Yes, I would, miss. June, lunch? June? June? Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Disabled, thank you very much. Santa Monica! Just the ticket! Scuba Dupa!
There he is! Stop that wheelchair!
Chair catches.
Look! I have told you before, I am not a lobster!
Oh, my God.
Dawn, what have you done?
I just didn't see
it. You mean you didn't look?
Well, how was I supposed to know? I mean, I just wasn't thinking.
Well, perhaps you should have thought about it.
Dawn, that's a piece of life you've raped there with this invalid's car.
Stupid, stupid cow!
Look, it's not my fault, right?
It's not her fault, Jennifer. It's the film industry's fault. The blame for this lies fairly and squarely on the shoulders of the British film industry.
I don't like that ending.
It's the only one we've got.
I know, I know. I just don't like it.
What are we going to do, then?
Well, you're the director.
Yeah, but you and Rick are the writers.
Yeah, yeah, but you get paid more than me.
Do I?
Well, let's just leave it obscure.
Through bull, we're going for a nosebag. Got me in five, over.
Like that, Julia. Like in some countries, polygamy can work very well.
What's polygamy, miss?
Well, I'll show you. Here's a mummy. And here's two daddies. Ah, good. Anna and Kate, you're back.
Sorry we're late, miss.
That's okay. Don't get hung up about punctuality because I'm always late for everything.
Here's a note for you, miss.
Thank you, Anna. Right. Well, I think that's about it for today. Class dismissed. Yes, Lucy?
It's not 10:02 yet, miss.
I must say I'm finding it very hard to relate to you these days, Lucy. Why do you have to be so pernickety all the time?
How do you spell pernickety, miss?
F-U-C-K-O-F-F. OK?
So I says to this pop singer bloke, I says, anyone who dyes his hair that colour is either mentally deranged or queer.
Well, they go up to London, they take drugs and they become homosexuals, don't they? I couldn't argue with that.
Well, that's a permissive society, Gerald.
Of course it is. Of course it is. I says to him, you may know everything about selling them chart records and so forth, but you know bugger all about high-density bulk yields.
You had to agree with me there.
This is adultery. You know that, don't you, Dave?
Right, 1-4 for a copy. Come back.
Marty's gonna kill you when he finds out. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, do it that way. I mean, I know he looks insipid, but when he's angry, he's really insane.
Bracken 1-4 for a copy. back.
You know, Martin loves me so much. He really does. It's just that I can't resist your oily body.
Crank your handle, come back.
Are you listening to me?
Just what's yours, come back.
This is Track Rider, pick a window, come back.
Dave, we're guilty.
Good. Let's go and snort some more coke.
We never seem to make love anymore, Susie.
Well, what do you expect? I'm teaching all day. I haven't got the energy. I've got to give up this job. It's obviously getting in the way.
I don't want to hold you back.
Oh, that's right, Martin. Make me feel guilty.
I'm not.
I feel like a trapped housewife, if you must know, Martin. Anyway, tell me about your day.
I was working in the garden this afternoon. And I saw that four of the onions had come up. It's strange. So I thought there'd be about 10 or 12 coming up.
That's really interesting, Martin.
So, I went indoors and looked it up in the book. And apparently, they don't always sprout at the same time.
Really?
Yes. So I thought the best thing was, you know, not to worry about it too much.
Yeah, good idea. You coming down the pub?
And what about Theodora?
Well, what about her?
You don't think she'll wake up?
Look, she's fine, Martin. Why don't you worry about me for a change?
Okay. Well, I'll just tuck her in and say goodnight then, shall I?
All right. Quickly then.
Let's enjoy ourselves.
Do you want another drink?
Okay.
Let's just enjoy ourselves. Just enjoy ourselves. Just you. Yes, you too. And you.
Ray, this book's just like me.
Yeah?
Yeah. I live in a big house, don't I? Look, I got servants and shit. It's weird, don't you think?
Yeah, but I think it's great you're so rich, Gary, because, you know, it really suits you.
Well, I'm glad I sold out when I did, because now I can buy anything I want, can't I?
Yeah, and it's my job just to get it for you, isn't it, Gary?
Yeah, and if I want any chicks or drugs, you'll just get them for me, won't you? If I feel like it.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Would you like some more coffee, Gary?
What do you think?
Well, we could have another cup, couldn't we?
What, now?
Well, yeah.
I don't know.
I tell you what I'll do. I'll pour the coffee into your cup, but I won't add the milk until you're really sure, okay?
Let me think about it.
Hello, Mr. Dreadful?
How are you?
He's the farm manager.
Oh, hello, Mr. Farm Manager. How are you?
Oh, very well, thank you. Nice day for lounging about inside, isn't it?
What's happening, FM?
Well, there's a chap here with a brand new £40,000 combine harvester that apparently somebody ordered.
Oh, yeah, that's mine. Where is it? Hey, I love it. It's beautiful. This is the kind of thing I want to spend my money on, Ray. Why don't we get a blue one for you? Then we can have races. What do you think?
Yeah. Does it come in any other colour?
No, just this normal, proper red sort of colour.
Well, couldn't we have it, you know, resprayed?
I dare say you could, but whatever the colour, it's certainly an asset for the harvest.
No.
I beg your pardon?
I don't want this thing used on the farm.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Dreadful, I don't quite follow you.
Listen, you know those films about the old days where you see, like, fields full of men, women and children toiling in the hot sun? Well, that's the kind of feel I want on my farm.
Yes, well, you had this big drug vision, didn't you, Gary, of this, you know, community of, like, cheap labour, doing everything by hand.
Anyway, that's the way I want to do it.
Take it easy, FM. Gary's got jet lag.
What's this flower, miss?
It's a yellow flower.
Well, what kind of yellow flower, miss?
Look, you've got a flower book, haven't you? Look it up.
Jeez.
Yeah, turn it up, right? Good. Isn't this great? Such a good feeling, isn't it? Doing things by hand. Terrific. Yeah, come on, let's take a ride around the estate now.
Where are we going now, miss?
Look, I just can't think straight with you kids bugging me all the time. I need to be on my own for a bit, okay?
What do we do then, miss?
Oh, I don't know. Improvise. Play doctors and nurses, whatever it is you kids do these days.
My house.
Hello.
Hello.
You know me?
No, should I?
I'm Gary Dreadful. I've just bought the manor house. All these fields, those cows, this road, everything.
Good for you.
I love you. Take care, you're beautiful. Oh, terrific. Get another one, Ray.
What's that smell?
Well, don't start that again. I had a bath yesterday.
Jesus Christ, you left the gas on again, haven't you? What are you trying to do, kill yourself?
Sorry, Dave, I put the kettle on and then I had to go and do something.
When's dinner?
Won't be a minute, dear. I just got you something special today. We're going Italian, all right?
Mm.
How's it going with the school teacher, then?
She's very neurotic.
You don't suppose she fits in down the village, does she? She's a bit blatant for around here. Well, what's Gary Dreadful like, then? Is he new wave or what?
New wave? He's at least 30.
What's nothing wrong with that. Hugh Cornwall's 35, and what about Adam Ant?
He's not 30.
He is.
He's not.
He is.
He's not, Mum.
Oh. Give me the glass.
No.
David, give me that glass.
It's for your own good.
I'll get another one.
No, you won't.
Get another one.
You going out again?
Yes. Don't mind, do you?
No. Just we never seem to see you these days.
You're seeing me now, aren't you? We're not joined at the hip, surely.
Will you be late home?
Oh, God. Questions, questions, I don't know.
Theodora missed you today.
Look, Martin, I object to you using that very demanding child to get at me.
I'm not.
Liar. You just know how to make me feel guilty. I'll do as much for that child as you do. Get away from me! Don't touch me with those indecisive fingers! Oh, don't cry, Martin! Can't stand it!
I love you, Susie.
Yes, yes, you've told me that.
I just want you to be happy. Do you want some money?
Shut up! Shall I wear this or the black? What do you think?
You look beautiful in the red.
I think I'll wear the black. Don't meet up for me.
Hi, you must be Ray.
Yes, I am. Who are you?
Oh, I'm Susie. I expect Gary's told you we're having a pretty wild affair. I mean, it's unbelievably intense, and I can hardly bear it. Trouble is, I've got a few problems, and I need time to think.
Yes, well, apparently you've been lying down quite a bit around the village.
Yes, I suppose I am a bit randy. Still, you know what school teachers are like.
Yes. Would you like a glass of champagne?
Oh, cheers. So how do you like being homosexual? Is it fun?
No, not really. In fact, I never really wanted to be gay, but I was, you know, forced into it by the recession.
Oh, what a pity. Mm. Still, Gary's not queer, though, is he?
Right?
Yes, Gary?
This is boring. There's not a fish in here. We've been ripped off.
Don't worry, Gary. We'll get some dynamite.
Good. Oh, hello, babe. How are you doing?
Hello, Gary. I've been missing you all day.
Yeah, I've been missing all day, too. Ray? Where's mammal nitrate? We're going for a walk.
Good all this, isn't it? Looks just like a record cover.
Yes.
I'm glad I got out of the metropolis. You know, it's hard living on the front line, seeing all your fans on the dole. It really does you ready.
Yes, unemployment is a bit of a drag, isn't it?
One day I said to myself, Gary, I said what? I said, Gary, I said, what do you want? Do you know what I'm saying?
This is like a strange dream, Gary. I feel like Julie Christie in that Thomas Hardy film.
What?
Well, you see, I don't know whether to leave Martin and live with Dave, or go with you and divorce Martin, or live with Martin and leave you, but still see Dave. What do you think?
I don't know. I didn't see the film.
Let's make love, Gary.
Nah, I can't do all that anymore.
What's wrong? Don't you love me?
No, it's not that. It's just I'm tired of this endless snobbing, that's all.
Oh, my poor darling.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the last few years have been oh so saucy, it's unbelievable.
In what way have they been so unbelievably saucy?
Oh, everything, the chicks, ducks. They weren't living creatures, they were just sex objects.
Another group here, you know. Bought the manor over at North Bush. Come on, yeah. Move it. Call themselves the Bee Gees. Ever heard of them?
Yeah, well, they were one of the super groups, weren't they?
That's right, super group. Anyway, they come up to me one day, they said, Mr. Pierce, do you think we play too loud? I said, frankly, lads, I think you do. So they turned it down, and of course they sold a million. And apparently they were right pleased with what I had to say about it.
I'm like Julie Christie, aren't I?
You're nothing like Julie Christie.
Well, some people think I'm like Julie Christie.
Yeah, well, you're not.
You know what the trouble with this relationship is, don't you?
What?
It's just sex.
So? What's the problem?
Well, doesn't it bother you?
Nope.
What do you think of Gary?
Why?
I just wondered how you two would get on, that's all.
We wouldn't.
Why are you so pissed off?
I'm not pissed off.
Thought you'd like Gary. He's a very now person.
Young German driver Manfred Winkelhock was racing as a famous Nürburgring in a...
Hey, Mr. Farm Manager, how are things going down on the farm?
Well, everything's just fine, thanks, Mr. Dreadful.
OK, let's go and cut down some trees, then.
Well, I got a couple of cows for the artificial insemination today.
OK, I'll come and watch that, then.
What's happening?
What do you mean?
I thought we were going to spend the day together.
Look, Martin, I've got things to do.
But it's Saturday.
Yes, but I've got to go up to the manor.
What for?
Well, it's this pop star. He said he might give some music lessons and, I was just going to go out and talk to him about it, that's all.
So I'll just carry this shopping home then, shall I?
Yeah, thanks, love. Don't wait up for me.
Listen, we got to talk. I've had second thoughts about all this Tom, Dick and Harry business.
Well, what do you mean?
You know, all those other blokes.
What about them?
Look, this is the real thing, Susie. I'm in love. So unless you drop those guys by, you know, tomorrow, I think you can just forget the whole thing. What do you say, yes or no?
I've thought about it, Gary.
And?
And I've decided to finish with Dave and Martin. From now on, I only want to be with you. Wherever you go, whatever you do, I'll be there. I love you. Than waves upon the sea.
Susie.
Yes?
Don't sing.
I'm going to live with Gary and have his children.
Well, it's been fun, hasn't it?
You're really brave. Aren't you just a bit upset?
Well, it hasn't quite sunk in yet.
Well, we can still be friends, can't we?
Sure.
You sure you're not going to go out and get drunk and beat somebody up because of me?
No chance.
You're taking this very well. What's going on? Have you got somebody else?
Martin?
You bitch! You horrible bitch! You whore! I hate you! You're just gonna walk out after 7 years, is that it?
I'm sorry, Martin.
Martin? Martin, Dave's dead.
I can't take it anymore, Susie.
And Gary's left me.
Susie, I want to kill myself.
So do I.
I'm so unhappy.
So am I. Isn't it funny how things happen in threes? First Gary leaves me, and then Dave dies, and now you're going to top yourself.
How did Dave kill himself?
He didn't. It was an accident. His mum left the gas on by mistake. I've really screwed things up, haven't I?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Martin. Let's start again.
Stay away from me! Don't touch me!
Please don't leave me, Martin. Life's too short to kill yourself.
Oh, what's the use?
If you do it, I'm going with you.
No!
Yes!
Just leave me alone!
Look, Martin, we can do it together. You know, not sordid, but nice and happy.
Shut up, Susie!
goodbye, Martin. Do it now.
Sorry, Susie.
No, I'm glad you're a lousy shot.
I guess I don't practice enough.
God, I've been such a bitch to you, haven't I? Trouble is, Martin, I began to find you so boring.
You didn't give me much of a chance.
I know. I've been like that since I left art school. It's not your fault.
Do you want to split up?
No. I'm not fit to live with anyone else. You're the only one who'll have me. Things wouldn't have worked out with Dave or Gary. Well, Dave, perhaps. He was a really nice guy.
I don't want to know.
No, but he was.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Darling?
Oh, excited.
Let me have another look.
So, what's your name?
Kenny.
Are you taking this train to El Paranzo?
Am I taking this train to what?
El Paranzo.
She says, are we taking this train to El Paranzo?
San Domingo. The next stop.
The next stop.
But this train doesn't stop at San Domingo.
This train will stop at San Domingo, old woman.
Senor?
It was an accident.
Vanishing.
10,000 pesetas.
Do you take traveler's checks?
What?
Tickets. Hey, what's this, Gringo? It's a Euro Rover, old man.
Yes, yeah. I am Argentine.
Everybody happy! Oh la 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 la! Oh, everybody happy! Oh la 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 la! Hey, where your mama gone? Where your mama gone? Where?
Vago. Tell me, amigo. What's the meanest, nastiest, dirtiest El Hotel in town?
Yes, for two mean, ugly, gunslinging
bastards like us to stay in for 2 weeks.
Ah, you want the hotel Bastardos? It's a bitch. This is the manager. He's my best friend.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Bastardos.
You'll be in my hotel at 4 o'clock, you bastard Inglese.
B&B for one night, Capitan.
Get your hands off my counter, you tourist filth!
I think I like this place. Make that 2 weeks.
Color TV in every room. Jacuzzi. Two bars. Disco. Every Friday. Where's the disco? Except October. I don't think I like this place.
I don't think I like you.
I don't think I heard that.
I don't think I said it.
I don't think. Therefore, I am.
Fire guns in the bedroom, eh? And no flashing of guns down the lavatory.
Hey, how come there's no soft toilet paper?
It's Hotel Bastardos. No soft toilet paper, Hotel Bastardos. You want a soft toilet paper? You go to Hotel Gay Boy. Hey, you're winging pommies. And another thing, you're not set fire to the beds, eh? Good, 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 good. Okay.
To a bed factory if I feel like it. Hotel Bastardos. It's more like Hotel Unpleasantos. This toilet thinks everything.
No, Thursday. The factory is still there. I'll tie both these children to.
Excuse me, is this the road to El Paranzo?
Yeah, and that's exactly where I'm going. Is that where you're going?
Yes, it is. Have a nice day.
What you got in those bags?
A picnic lunch.
Ha
to be on a sissy leading rein anymore.
No, neither do I.
Bastard horse, do what I'm saying, or it's a kitty cat factory for you. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Blonde German guys with cute hips and leather pants.
Yeah, Nazi tattoos. Do me a favour, Shona. Get politically aware, why don't you?
Where do you want to go then? Venice? That's got a lot of art.
No, I've been there. It stinks. Do you know they built it on a lake? Can you believe it?
It's got sand and it's got a sex life, Jackie.
Stroop, you go like a bunny, Shona. You've only been gone 6 weeks.
Look, Jackie, what is the point in coming to Europe and not getting laid?
Well, what about him?
Struth, what a disaster.
Yeah, kind of guy who gives you crabs. You okay? He's passed out.
Must be Pommy.
I don't know where it is you're going, but I'm coming with you. And staying with you. Have you got any Mandy's?
Hey. Oh. I'm Jackie and this is Shona. What's your name?
What's this? Oh. Sorry, man. I just put cigarette and ash and that all over your duvet. Oh. Shall I clean it up with this?
No.
Oh. I know, I'll turn it over so you won't see it. Well then, I'm Paul. What's your name?
I'm Jackie and this is Shona.
Hi.
Oh, hello, Shona. What, you speak English, do you?
Oh, yeah, we're Aussies.
Oh, look, Wellard, look, can you cash a gyro? I mean, I've got this gyro, see, it's valid and everything, but I couldn't cash it before the ferry went, right? Because Julie, that's my daughter, Julie, right, set fire to my bag, man. Have you got any cash, have you?
start the row. I went first last time. No, you didn't.
Did not.
You calling me a liar?
So, have we started yet?
Of course I have, you great tosser.
Right, start again.
You calling me a liar?
Yes.
Well, then you're going to die.
Sorry about this, man. It's just, I've got this stomach upset. Just here in my stomach. Means I've got to go to the toilet every 10 minutes.
Off you go then, Paul.
You're not going to drive off without me or anything like that, are you?
Oh, no, Paul.
Well, I'm just going to take these keys in case you're lying.
Let's make it about football this time.
Yeah.
Which football team do you support?
Watford.
Watford can't play to save their lives, amigo.
I agree.
Oh. Oh, well, then I don't agree. I think they can play. They just need a new manager.
Yeah.
Anyway, you're going to die.
I think...
What is it, amigo?
I think I'm getting a suntan.
No. Where's the bog? The bog.
No te entiendo.
El poco.
Tienes pinta borracho.
Where's the bog?
No te entiendo. Nada.
You gonna eat all that food, are you?
Fuck off!
Oh, what? You're English? I'm Paul. Let's shake hands.
You're in trouble!
Yeah, well, it's not so bad now, because I've got a ride off these, Australian chicks. I think one of them's going to cash my gyro. That's them over there.
Which one's gyro?
I don't know. But I'm probably going to end up sleeping with one of them tonight. That one with the big tits and the money.
I think I'm a bit peckish.
Yes. This killing is hungry work, amigo. And you and I have not yet had our elevenses. Where's the packed lunch?
It's on the horses.
Oh. What do you mean we haven't got any food? Well, BF, I'm absolutely starving. Hey, have a rock cake, amigo.
I'm a matador, but I lost my driving license. Now I work up at Abattoir.
So what you want to do? You want to come with us, do you? You could probably have the spare one, you know, if you want, I expect. Have you got any drugs?
I'm a mass murderer, I am.
That's cool. We've all got to be something. What sign are you, man?
Trouble.
Yeah, nice one. Yeah. Look, I'll fix it all up, all right? I'll fix it all up. You'll be all right. You're definitely coming with us, all right? Okay, stay there. Don't worry. And I'll have that, yeah? Shona, how are you? Listen. I've run into trouble, and he wants to come with us.
Well, if you ask me, it looks like a right deal. Yeah, no more freeloaders, thank you. He might be a mass murderer, for all you know.
He is, man. But he's all right.
Look, the answer is definitely no, so give me the keys back.
Oh, look, no, come on, man. Look, you'll be all right, right? He's all right. Look, I swear. Look, on my daughter's life, right, I swear. I really promised that everything would be okay, right?
Hi, I'm Shona and this is Jackie. What do you do for a living, Trouble?
Take your clothes off.
Yeah, let's have a party.
Not you, him. Take your clothes off.
What did you just say?
Take your clothes off!
Take this poor little snake into your arms, and there it may find peace and happiness. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
You just landed on our grave.
It's not my fault. I was thrown out of a VW. I weren't doing nothing, though.
Shut up. Who sent you?
A bloke called Paul. He's a bastard.
Who are you?
I can't remember.
So, you're the man with no name?
Yeah, that's me. Billy Belfort. The man with no name.
In that case, we'll call you Trevor.
And I'll call you next week.
Not so fast, no name. We're not finished with you yet. We want information.
Eh?
Have you got any sandwiches?
No.
What about biscuits?
No.
Crisps?
No.
Chewing gum?
No.
What about some cake? What about chocolate cake? With hundreds and thousands. And no marzipan.
Look, I haven't got any food. I haven't got any sudden food.
Well then, you're going to die. Say your prayers, amigo.
Which one? I don't know any prayers.
Well, then perhaps you should have paid more attention in divinity class. You might have lived 5 minutes longer.
Wait! I know where there's a cafe. It's great! They specialize in food!
It's a trick.
Prove it.
Just there.
Come on, keep it going.
Keep calm, Julie. That's a very big bus. There could be six people in there. Jesus, if they only buy coffee, it's enough to pay the ground rent. Okay, let's give them a good time, you and me. I'll put on the music, you light the candle. What do they like? What do they like? Come on, come on, what do they like? The Eagles, yeah! Everybody likes the Eagles. D4.
Welcome to. Come on! Oh, I don't believe it. I don't believe it.
Hello?
Just bought this.
Is that where the 10p's go then, is it?
Anywhere, sir. Anywhere. I kind of thought you might like this table. It's got the best tablecloth and view.
Oh. Can I drink this?
For sure. Can I join you?
Okay.
Are you on your own? That's an awfully big bus to be driving around on your own. I kind of hoped, thought there might be some others.
No. Listen. What I think we should do is, you and I should talk. Just talk. Sitting here until they've finished, you know, the business. Whatever.
Look, Jackie, I've had enough. I mean, if I so much as see that pull me again, I'm going to be sick right over the back seat, and that's for real.
Look, if you really want to get rid of him, why don't you dump his bag and we'll drive off?
Good idea. Oh, Jesus. Might as well do it properly while we're here.
Yeah, you'll be doing him a favour.
Burn. Oh, Jesus, Jackie, look.
Looks like take your clothes off time.
Yeah, and he's got a couple of pals with him as well.
Oh, come on. Oh, fuck this Dago petrol. Right, what do we do?
Quick, my ladies.
Oh, Jesus, don't these deserts make you want to piss a lot?
Hello? Look! It's them bastards what threw me over the cliff!
Guys, Can I make you a cocktail?
Whiskey. And steaks.
Okay, two steaks. Wow. Two steaks coming right up.
Wait. Make that four. Each. Six. Eight. Ten.
Oh, come on, guys. 10 steaks each. Are you joking?
Do we look like comedians? What do you call a man with his ding-a-ling and a piece of melon?
I don't know.
Christopher. See what I mean? Now get the steaks, amigo.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Paul.
Paul who?
Paul, can you cash a gyro or have you got any Mandy's? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, look, here comes Trouble. Hello, Trouble. How are you, man?
You bastard! Where's those women?
Oh my God, Shanna! The rapist's killing Paul!
Oh, that's a blessing.
Okay, so you're going to send a squad car around. Uh-huh. Okay. Would you mind waiting until they settle the check? Thank you. Have a nice day. Take it easy, guys. I don't have a fight license.
Where's your bastard women?
Shut up!
So I couldn't decide whether to have blue or green, so I got both. Because I thought that if you're drinking, like, rosé, you don't want to have to look at a pink tablecloth, right?
Where's them bastard women?
Personally, I don't care about the color of a tablecloth. The most important thing is to relax and just get along with people.
Where's them bastard women?
I think it's time to move on.
Hey.
John Paul, George, and Gringo.
Thank you.
From the police?
Don't worry.
I hate the bastards. They towed my car away last week. You can come through the back way if you like.
What have you done?
Nothing much.
You're not violent, are you?
No.
Actually, I'm a writer. I wondered if you'd be interested in this script I've written. It's a 30-minute TV play aimed at young people. I mean, that's what I'm interested in. Do you like plays for young people?
Yes.
I've tried several of the TV companies. Bastards. It's too controversial, that's the problem. I mean, I could write that shit. But what's the point in compromising? Life's too short, really, isn't it? Do you want some more tea?
No, listen, where's your back door?
It's blocked up. I can't open it. This is a good bit. This guy's your age, and he meets a sailor at the pub. He says, "I bet she's good at it," nodding to the girl at the bar. Sailor? Not me, mate. I'm queer. What do you see in girls? I don't know. It's supposed to be North Country. I can't do the accent. Shit. Don't worry, I'll sort this out. This is a bit much, isn't it? I'm trying to work.
Police.
Now, look here. I'm sick of you bastards coming round here. My car was towed away. There was no apology. And you have the nerve to demand £30 for its return. What is this? Russia, Herr Führer?
One time, sir. Take your hat.
West End, please, Gov.
I'm finishing my lunch first.
Quick! It's important!
Don't tell me what's important, John. I've got angina. Do you know what that means? That means I've got to eat slowly, otherwise I'll die. Then you won't be going anywhere in this cab, will you? Come in. I mean, look at that. Rush. See him. Heart attack.
Look, I've got to get to an hospital. It's an emergency. I'm a nuclear scientist and I've been exposed to radiation.
Out of cab.
All right, look, I'm sorry. The police are after me, but it's not my fault. It's a case of mistaken identity, really.
Hello. I got him. He's here. Help. I got him. He's here. He's...
me, do you have a light?
No, sorry.
Oh dear, I'm bursting for a ciggy. I don't smoke normally, but I'm so nervous. Capital Radio. Do you listen to Capital Radio? I'm doing a special interview there in half an hour. That's why I'm so nervous. Is your meter not working?
No.
Oh. My Alan, bring you just a little bit more. Right, how much do I owe then?
Pound?
Oh dear, can you change a fiver?
No, sorry, no.
Well, what about that little purse dangling there?
Cheers.
Oh, your hand, you cut yourself.
Yeah.
Oh my God, and your face. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
Oh well, take care then, bye.
Bye.
Bryanston Square, please.
How much?
That'll be £3.90 for you, cheers, Scott.
£3.90. I've had a good day. Keep the change. Lucky boy.
Drive! Just drive anywhere, it's all right, I'll pay. How much do I owe you? Is it? I'm supposed to be at work at 9. But where are we anyway?
Essex.
No, I'm really sorry. I don't know much about last night. I don't really know who you are. What am I supposed to be doing in Essex?
You got a fang?
Yeah. Do you mind driving me back? Why, have you nicked it or something?
No. I'm the heart attack taxi thief.
All right. I'm Angie, pleased to meet you.
Hello.
Do you want a lift?
Yeah, thanks.
Be quick, I'm in a hurry. Hi, I'm Max. How are you? Here, take this.
Oh, thanks.
Don't thank me. Just strap yourself in case I turn this thing over. Son of a bitch!
Didn't expect you to do that.
I'm an epileptic. Well, I've been all right since Christmas. My wife says I'm crazy and ought to be locked up. Perhaps she's right. God, she's beautiful. Wish I could see her. She won't let me in the house without a lawyer. I mean, that's not a proper marriage, is it? Huh? Are you married?
No.
It's the nights I can't take. It was all right at first, stayed with friends. But you know what it's like when you start falling over and frightening the children. And then in the morning it was Max. Can you go now? I said, Mary, it's 5:30 in the morning. She said, I'm sorry, Max. I'm sorry. I don't feel safe while you're in the house. Cigarette? Cheers. Of course, I admit it, I'm a bit of a mess just now. I haven't slept for 7 days. I'm a nice guy, aren't I? What the fuck is going on? I've been driving around in this car for 3 days and I don't know who I am anymore. And it's down to this. If someone doesn't start to understand me right now, I'm going to kill us all, and I mean it. Am I coming across?
Look, Max, we've got our own problems, right?
Look, Max, when this car slows down, I'm going to get out and kick the shit out of you.
All you have to do is call her. Tell her I'm sorry, and I'll do anything. Anything she wants. She'll listen to you, I know. Tell her I love her and I'm really calmed down. Don't say you know me and talk quick before she puts the phone down.
Who should I say is calling?
Just say I'm sorry and that, is it ringing?
Yeah.
Oh, God, she's probably gone jogging. She's maybe met someone else. Oh, God, I hope he doesn't answer the phone. Do you think she's met somebody else? What's something? Do you want some money?
Oh, for God's sake, just stop jabbering.
Oh, okay, I'll shut up.
What's her name?
Phillips.
Hello, Mrs. Phillips. You don't know me. My name's, Andrew Taylor.
What did you say?
No, he's alive.
Have some more money.
Well, do you want to do this?
No, just say I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's just if you really, really can't talk to him, Mrs. Phillips, then he's very likely to kill not only himself, but me and my boyfriend as well. No, it's the way he drives. Yeah, I agree, he's a self-indulgent little worm.
Just say I'm sorry, and I've really changed.
Yeah, keep saying you're sorry. Look, here's Max, bye.
I love you!
We're from London and we've broken down. Did you breakfast?
No, sorry.
Look, I'm sorry, I know it's a cheek and everything, but you know, we're really hungry. We'll pay you.
Well, all right then. We haven't got very much. Come in.
Since our accident, do we, Franny? She hates me calling her Franny. Her real name's Frances, but I call her Franny.
You're a chicken farmer?
No, I'm a PE instructor.
May I use a bathroom, please?
Yes, it's through there. Oh, you've cut your hand.
Yeah, it's nothing very much.
What was it, a head-on collision? Or did you smash into a tree, blind drunk?
Tim?
We'd both been drinking, you see, heavily. And Franny said, oh, I'll drive home. Next thing, crash! I'd lost both legs. Still, at least she'd lost her license. Well, what do you do?
I'm a typist.
Oh, really? I thought you were a prostitute.
Charming.
How much do you charge? Do you take a cheque, do you?
Tim, stop it!
Tim, stop it! Tim, stop it! Tim, stop it! That's a typical Franny remark! Franny's a nymphomaniac too, aren't you, Franny? Aren't you a nymphomaniac, Franny? She'd kill me if she thought she'd get away with it.
Would you mind cutting some bread for me? Breakfast is very nearly ready.
Ah, the pimp. I was just talking to your call girlfriend about doing it in doorways. Well, I must say, you're a gutless little swine, aren't you? You scratching, loathsome piece of filth with your diseased trollop. Pimp. Whore. Pimp. Whore. Pimp. Whore. Pimp. Whore. Pimp. Whore. Pimp. Whore.
Sorry about that, kids. Too good a chance to miss. You can't look a gift horse in the mouth, can you?
You've killed him.
Huh. Well, I hope so, yes. Hello, police? Oh, my God, something tragic has happened. My husband's been murdered. Yes, it was that boy. You know, the taxi one in the papers. Yes, he's murdered my husband right through the heart with a carving knife. Yes? Yes, it was a wedding present, actually.
Would you mind signing this order form? I'm on holiday next week, you see.
I'm going to tell you something now. I don't want you to react in any way, do you understand?
I beg your pardon?
I'm a police officer and I'm aware of your situation. Do you follow?
Oh, yes.
Just answer this next question, yes or no. Are they inside?
No.
Are they in the immediate vicinity?
Yes.
Right. Just relax. Everything's under control. I'd just like you to take two steps backwards into the house. Good girl. You're doing very well there.
Frances.
Lovely name for a lovely lady.
Thank you.
Now, Franny, what I want you to do is, without looking or pointing in any way, I want you to tell me exactly where they are.
They're in the mini.
Good.
So that's 2 pints tomorrow, is it?
Yes!
The mini.
The mini.
Just one for you to sign for, madam.
Right, Fran, what I want you to do now is to go into your living room.
Yes.
You got that? Now, have you got any thick cushions or a rug in there?
No. But I've got a duvet.
Oh, that'll do the trick. They're nice, aren't they? Better than making the old bed every day.
Yes, I'd never go back to sheets and blankets.
Right. Now, Fran, what I want you to do is to go into your living room and lie on the floor with the duvet over you. Have you got that?
Yes.
Now, in a few moments, you're going to hear a bit of a bang. So I'd like you to stay in that position until myself or a fellow officer gives you the all clear. Is that understood?
Yes.
Good girl. Off you go, then.
Be careful.
Stand by. Go! Shit!
hand, Gino.
You're not kidding.
Look, don't you think you should just call the solicitor, you know, have a chat about
that? No, I don't. Come on.
Gordon, shall I put the key under the mat then?
Yes.
Have you got the cash?
Yes.
What are we flying? Being AC?
No.
Oh, well, so long as it's British.
Yes.
Yes, yes, absolutely splendid, yes.
Jolly top hole, Bungie.
Bagged anything?
No. Not yet. Good afternoon. This is a robbery. Pipe down, old chap. I'll splash your brains right across that wonderful antique counter.
We have your best double room, please?
Well, they're all the same.
Now, look, we've got a load of bread and we're used to good treatment, so what we want is champagne and special service.
I'm sorry. We don't provide that type of extra.
You don't understand. Look. See this? Now, if we get what we want, you get this. All right then. Well, if that's the case, I'll have two steaks, all the trimmings. Yeah, champagne. Half a dozen cigars and some flowers, please. Thank you. There, see? Money talks.
The hunt is still continuing for the so-called heart attack taxi thief. And today the police were piecing together the amazing trail of the wanted fugitive. Dave Hallihan reports.
It was 10:30 yesterday morning on this quiet Victorian estate when the wanted man burst into the home of playwright William Shooney, who lives alone.
I was aware that at any moment this man was likely to slit my throat from ear to ear.
How did you react?
Well, he was ranting to me about how he was going to get Mrs. Thatcher, and I pretended to agree with him. He then smashed his way through this window here, using that chair there.
The wanted man then hijacked a black taxi cab from this man, John Troer, now in hospital recovering from a heart attack.
I was seconds. I was literally seconds away from death. This kind of incident is happening more and more, and I think the government should wake up and realise that taxi drivers should be armed. Like the police.
Another man who encountered the fugitive was actor Alan Peeley.
Well, he seemed quite nice, really. And when the police told me he was a vicious armed robber, well, I was stunned.
Were you frightened?
No, not at all. Like, I'll go and see him in prison if he wants me to.
Then he put a hole in my ceiling and said he was going to splash my brains right over the counter.
He did.
A violent stabbing that resulted in the death of a cripple on a deserted chicken farm in the area is now thought to be...
Come in.
May I open the champagne, sir?
It's a good idea.
You were here on holiday?
Yeah.
Some very nice Norman churches around here. Are you interested in churches, sir?
Why?
Oh, no reason. I just find religion particularly comforting in times of stress. You know, I think it helps to be philosophical when facing human issues like death, for instance.
What are you talking about?
You both want cabbage?
I've seen you somewhere before.
Really? Where was that, do you think?
Hold it, don't move. Get away from the trolley. Put your hands up in the air.
What's going on?
That's the milk policeman.
Gina's quite right, Angie. I'm a police officer.
Get your hands up. Get the gun.
I was just thinking on my way up here, Gina. I thought, what's the boy done? He's robbed a post office, stolen a few cars. And I thought, what's that worth? About 5 years. Maybe 3 years with good behaviour. Out there, Gina, there are 50 armed bully boys offering certain death in the event of an injury to a fellow officer. So I thought, what would I do in your position? Come down the station for a chat or die in a hail of bullets?
Yeah. I saw what you did to that mini, you arsehole.
Then I thought, you lucky bastard. What a celebrity. Papers queuing to buy your story. You know, checkbook journalism. Film producers paying thousands for the film rights. I thought, that's crime for you. 3 years in the nick, you wind up a millionaire.
Shoot on sight, says President.
On last night's television programme, Eddie at Large, Monsoon referred to President Idi Amin as Fatty Bum Bum.
TV row over dog killing.
Monsoon said,
it's a great shame. I offered to let him shoot my wife's dog and call it quits, but he just kept on crying.
Ban drunken Antichrist,
says Bishop.
Monsoon, Eddie. Goodbye, Doreen.
I nearly killed myself in suicide hoax, says Eddie Monsoon.
TV comedy shocker is banned. Too much sex and violence. Too shocking, even for Channel 4.
Just some of the headlines behind the enigma that is Eddie Monsoon. The tip of the iceberg of an amazing portfolio of adverse publicity which would shame any man into the depths of alcoholic despair and drug dependency. It was a decline into just such a state after Eddie's first British television show was so cruelly scrapped a fortnight before transmission, that led to Eddie's readmission to this particular institution, his 17th visit in 18 months.
Eddie, in the interview granted to me by your mother, Eunice, she said, and I quote, at the age of 12, Eddie was a sweet boy whose only ambition was to work in an old folks' home. And yet you see, at 28, you're a self-confessed drug addict, an incurable alcoholic divorcee, a bankrupt exile stroke fugitive of five African and South American states, and you have court cases pending in various countries on charges of tax evasion, sedition, and bestial rape. Now, what went wrong? Are you disappointed that you failed to achieve your original ambition? Eddie, does it hurt to talk about it?
How much money am I getting for this?
Give
us a fag, will you?
Oh, yeah, I think I've got one somewhere. Hang on.
Okay. Have you got a light?
Mr. Monsoon!
I wasn't going to smoke it, I promise. It was an accident. I was just going to show him a trick. Look.
Oh, you silly... Now, spit it out, come on. Stop coughing. I'll thank you not to give Mr. Monsoon any more cigarettes. I think cancer of one lung is quite sufficient, thank you.
This is my nurse, Veronica. They gave me an ugly old bat to begin with, but I signed a couple of checks and look what I got. A real little cutie. Isn't that right, Veronica?
Eddie, are you all right?
Oh!
Now, it's time for flip-flop and flip-flop. Hello, flip-flop. Hello, Eddie. Hello, flip-flop. Hello, Eddie. Look, will you shut up? Shut up and keep still, for God's sake, you'll be having like children! Come here!
Right then. Hello, Plip-Plop. How are you today? I need to go to the lavatory. Wouldn't you like to sing a song first? Only if it's my favourite song, Flippity-Flop and Plippity-Plop. What a great idea. Music maestro, please. Flippity flop and flippity plop. Slip slop, slippity slop. Get away from me! Everybody, get away! Get away! I've got a gun here and I'm not afraid to use it!
You made quite a few pilots in South Africa.
Yeah.
That was my fifth pilot for that particular company.
Oh, it wasn't made into a series?
It was shortly after it was made, 3 hours to be exact, that I'd left South Africa.
Ah, yes, amidst rumours of suicide.
That's all lies, Tony. I never committed suicide. Well, what happened was this. I got very drunk and thought stupidly that I'd be able to swim to Madagascar. I must have passed out after a couple of minutes in the water, because when I woke up, I found myself lying on the beach. So I dumped the gear, disguised myself as a nun, got on the wrong plane, and found myself in Brazil.
That's an extraordinary story. What did you actually do when you got there?
Luckily, I fell in with the old German expatriate crowd. And that's when I developed my new quiz show, How Pure Was Your Grandpapa? Didn't do much business in Brazil, but it was quite a hit in Austria.
But what about your considerable interests in South Africa? I mean, your father's firm, your nightclub, Eddie's Sex Palace, and the Eddie Monsoon pet shop chain. I mean, what of them?
Well, I couldn't go back because of the legal position. And then there was my wife, of course. She was part of the reason I left in the first place.
Eddie Monsoon broke my heart. He had his faults, but I loved him. He was the most precious thing in the world to me, ever. Excuse me. Hello? Yes? Oh, Damien. How are you? Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm fine. Well, I am now. No, don't stop it. I'm sorry. No, Damien, I've got to go now. Yes, I've got guests. It's Channel 4. It's about Eddie. Well, it's 500 quid, love. Right, I'll ring you as soon as possible. He ruined my life. But he was the only man I ever loved. I think I could... I could have put up with his relentless alcoholism, you know, his cruelty to animals, the way he used to shout in his sleep, even his suicide, you know. But to turn up after 18 months, you know, out of the blue, with a German accent and an Argentine passport, you know, after I had already remarried twice, well, I had to divorce him. Actually, I never really liked him. It's an embarrassment, really, you know. Those dreadful programmes of his, as you know.
And the weather today? Surprise, surprise, it's too bloody hot again. But never mind, because here's today's star quiz.
Star quiz, guess who it is?
Yeah, all I want to know is who this is and the year, right? Here it comes. It's a bit of a trick question, so I'm giving away, this microphone to the first person who phones in with the title of Stranger on the Shore.
Tiny Townsend, impresario and Eddie Monsoon's business manager from August 1982 to January 1983. And when did you first get involved with Eddie?
Look, let's get one thing straight from the start. I have never been involved with Eddie Monsoon. And I have written legal statements to prove that.
Ah, but...
Never mind, but. You can't go around saying things like that. I want to put this on the record. I have never met Eddie Monsoon... Hardly, and when I did, it was always in the presence of a third party.
Me and Tiny were like... We were like that. He was my best friend. A bastard, of course, but a very nice bastard.
Now, you were saying?
Yes, I was trying to define the extent of your relationship.
Hang on. Just give us a blast for the level, will you?
What?
Count 1, 2, 1, 2.
Oh, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2.
Good, fine, we're in business. Right, off you go and keep it nice and clean.
Of course. Well, let me put it this way. Have you ever encountered Eddie Monsoon in a social situation with a third party present?
Yes. It was on, August the 28th, 1981, at approximately 2:30 p.m. Eddie came to me with an idea. It was very sick.
And now, remove the blades, and it is immediately transformed into a simple and effective household drill. Very much. But now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Eddie Monsoon and who's talking? Penis.
No, 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 not this talking penis thing. You call that tasteless. Oh no, this was, look, I am not a prude, right? I have to admit that, as regards taste, I have done a few things in my time that juries have found disgusting. I think that was the word. But, this idea of Eddie's, made even me feel slightly queasy.
What was this idea?
Suffice to say, the viewers would not like it, Tony.
Did it have anything to do with seal pups and cans of spray paint?
What?
Eddie says that you took his idea for spray painting baby seals live on stage.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And that you used it in the show you produced called Joseph and His Amazing Psychedelic Fur Coat.
Look, you promised me you would keep this clean. Everyone knows I have done foul and perverted things in the past, but I didn't get away with it. I was nicked. I have done my time. 3 years. I have paid my debt to society. I am a straight man, I am clean, I am a reformed man, so don't you talk to me about filth!
Oh. An affair with Tiny? I mean, don't be ridiculous. Well, it only lasted a couple of months, actually. And, you know, I don't think Eddie would have found out if Tiny hadn't bought me that beautiful rainbow fur. That, I think, was really what upset our hopes, you know, for remarriage. But it didn't really bother me, because, of course, I had settled out of court for a huge alimony from the first time round, you see, and then became a lesbian. Gin, Mr. Bilbo. Or can I call you Tommy?
Actually, it's Tony.
Whichever you prefer.
Tiny can be very cruel, though. I mean, I liked that danger routine. It was a great act. I loved it. But who was it that had to go to the hospital every night and get stitched up? Me. Look, look, you can still see the scars.
Oh dear, yes, yes, yes.
Ah! Oh. Sorry. Sorry, I just felt like it. Of course, you kept me virtually anaesthetized with drugs and... Oh, it was an accident. It was an accident.
Now, you were Eddie's manager for a period of 17 months.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I mean, no.
No?
Yes, no.
Ah.
I mean, that agreement was rescinded on the grounds of my diminished responsibility. I've got the papers to prove it.
But that doesn't mean you weren't Eddie's manager, does it?
Yes.
All right, let me put it another way. Are you trying to tell me that you never made any money out of Eddie?
Yes.
You can't be serious.
Next question.
You never made any money out of Eddie?
I don't want to talk about it.
Not a penny?
Nothing.
C-
Come now, Mr. Townsend.
Look, I've already told you I never made any money out of Eddie Monsoon.
But, Mr. Townsend, we all know...
That's it. End of interview. Go on, get out. All of you, get out! Look, the only money I ever made out of Eddie Monsoon was when I sued him. Oh, God!
Well, he's a manic depressive, you know. Perfectly all right and controllable when he's severely depressed. But as soon as he gets happy, well, he's very violent.
Are you trying to say that he's a naturally violent person?
Well, there's some medical term for it. But, well, let me put it this way. He's an absolute mess. I mean, you can't tell what he's really like because he's always drugged out of his head. Either on the stuff, you know, he gets for himself, or stuff the doctors give him.
What is he actually being treated for?
You really want to know?
Yes.
Well, there's the asthma. Let's start with the mild ones, eh? Asthma, epilepsy, and congenital syphilis. Those are the ones that he was born with. Then there's the recurrent malaria, beriberi, and dengue fever. Those are the African ones. His liver's shot to pieces. I mean, he's got chronic constipation and congested piles, neither of which are helped by the fact that his rectum keeps prolapsing. Mind you, I mean, I personally think he enjoys that. Because, I mean, he keeps giving himself coughing fits just so as it drops out. I mean, I said to the doctor the other day, I said, give him a shoehorn, let him get on with it. Anyway, to cap it all, he has got the big C. You know, he's got sort of walk down here.
It is ironic that Eddie's first pilot for a British television show, recorded at a studio just 3 miles down the road from this hospital, should have been entitled Back to Normal.
Good evening, you. Good evening, you bastards. My name is Eddie Monsoon, and this is my first British television show. This is my bottle of scotch, which is Scottish. These are my cigarettes. I don't know where they came from. Probably out of a machine. Let me tell you all a bit about myself. My hobbies are drinking, smoking, swearing, and grass shooting. I am not a cripple, and I do not believe in self-control. I hate soft drinks, racing drivers, everyone who lives on the Isle of Wight, blind people, last orders, and stupid hard-faced cows who say they'll do it and don't even when they're pissed.
Yet more muscle seems to have been given to the clean-up television campaign recently, following the withdrawal of yet another programme before transmission on the grounds of the extreme sexual and violent content. In the studio tonight, we have Mr. Michael White, the executive producer, and Mr. Eddie Monsoon, the host of the programme Back to Normal with Eddie Monsoon.
The star.
Sorry?
The star of the programme.
Yes, I'm sorry.
I'm a star, not just a bloody host.
All right, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I couldn't help it. I'm just so tired. I haven't slept since Thursday.
Really?
Thursday, the 16th of January, actually. The day you banned my television programme.
Look, I'm sorry, Eddie.
What'd you have to go and do that for, eh? What have I ever done to you? Why'd you have to go and ban it just like that? My first ever British television programme.
Look, Eddie, I told you. It was purely a production decision.
I just don't understand.
It was...
I mean, Channel 4 is the channel for child porn and homosexuals. And I had both in my show.
Listen, Eddie...
So why'd you have to go and ban it just like that?
Eddie, if you really want to know...
Yes, I do!
Then shut up and listen. The only reasons we had for not transmitting Back to Normal with Eddie Monsoon are that it was obscene, libelous, and, in my opinion, an offence to humanity.
Yes, well, that seems to be, a fairly direct and honest summary of Mr. White's position. Mr. Monsoon, what do you say to that?
Shut your face!
What?
Name me one thing, just one thing, in that entire programme that you find offensive.
The item about how to get big things in your mouth.
Is that all? We could have cut that.
The things you said about Burt Reynolds. The bit about stiffies. Oh. The cruelty to animals.
All right, enough! Enough! Look, Michael, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Luke. I promise it won't happen again. Just give me another chance. Please. Please, Michael, just let me have a TV show of my own. I'll do anything for you. I'll give you a blowjob. Anything. Please, Mike. Michael. Michael, come back. Let me give you a...
I love my TV. I can't live without TV appearances. I haven't seen myself on TV for months now. I know Tiny's got a lot of my old South African shows on tape.
Mr. Townsend, come on, Mr. Townsend. Just a few more questions, please. And what about the pirate videos we found on sale? Which were just compilation tapes of Eddie's various television shows, being sold under the name Video Sex, a registered subsidiary of Tiny Townsend Limited. Now, how do you account for that, Mr. Townsend?
Look, I do not know what a video is, and my name is not Tiny Townsend. Not legally, anyhow.
Oh, dear, you've crashed your car, Mr. Townsend. That's a bit silly. And what about the pirate records, Mr. Townsend? And the gross mismanagement and misappropriation of funds from the Eddie Monsoon fan club for sick people?
Tell me, Eddie, what is it that makes you the man you are?
Charisma, Tony. I've got bags of charisma.
Yeah, but what is it about you that makes people want to exploit you? I mean, you've got no particular skill, no particular talent.
Talent is only a stumbling block, Tony. What I've got is fame, charm, charisma and legend.
But you're a total unknown.
That's a perverted lie, Tony. I could go to any high street in this land and the people would go crazy.
Excuse me, mate, excuse me. It's your lucky day, isn't it?
What's that for, then?
Guess who you're speaking to?
Guess who I am speaking to?
Yeah!
I got no idea.
Who the hell's Eddie Monsoon?
What does the name Eddie Monsoon mean to you?
Nothing at all.
Nothing!
Perhaps you know my name!
No, I don't.
No? What do you mean, no?
No, I haven't heard of it.
Perhaps I could ask your dog. Excuse me. Perhaps you've heard of Eddie Monsoon. Yes, yes, I have. I have really heard of him. There we are, you see? What do you think of my TV shows?
I haven't seen them, as a matter of fact. Sorry.
Ah, you probably haven't got a television, then.
Three.
Never heard of you.
Why doesn't anybody in this bloody town recognise me? Don't you recognise me, you bastards? Why don't you love me?
I want to go home.
Stop it, I want to go home now. Do you recognise any monsters?
Yeah.
Yes, he recognises me. And you're not my father, are you?
No, I'm your uncle.
How much money did you say I was going to get for this?
It's still being negotiated, Eddie.
No, but about that much, exactly.
Well, it'll be more than 3,000, Eddie, but I mean, it's really the producer's department.
Was that cheque or cash?
It's nothing to do with me, Eddie. I've told you, it's the producer's department.
When do I get it? Get off my blankets.
Look, Eddie, I don't know. Ask Sarah. She'll be in later.
Well, how do I know you're going to pay me?
Eddie!
You mean I have to trust you? Tony, I tell you what, you could pay me in scotch. That's not much, is it? 10 quid or something. Worse still, you get all the film you want and then kill me just to get out of paying me. Yeah, that's probably what you'd do. So get me some scotch, you bastards, or I'll stop talking. I mean it. I want some scotch. I'm going to stop talking now.
Is she here, then?
Yes, Eddie.
Hello, Eddie. I bought you a present. Look. Shall I open it for you? Oh, Eddie. Look, it's your favorite. Mother thingamies on motorbikes. Eddie. Corey. I'm over here. Hello. Well, we haven't seen each other for 18 months. Isn't there anything you want to say?
I had diarrhea yesterday.
Oh, Eddie. Same old funny old mackerel. Have you been drinking, Eddie?
It's my aftershave.
It's very nice. Are they looking after you well?
They've broken my arm and my leg.
I'm sure they know what they're doing. What is the matter, darling?
I've been sick. Just have the scotch to get rid of the taste.
I'm sorry. I have to go, Eddie. I have an appointment. I love you, Eddie. And by the way, you're behind on the payments.
Last night, Eddie seemed very happy, very calm, very relaxed, very drunk. He'd had a traumatic day. In the morning, he cut himself on the knee quite badly while shaving. His lunch was ruined by the news of the death of Tiny Townsend after a week in intensive care after a car accident. Then, of course, in the afternoon, there was the difficult reunion with his estranged wife. But after her departure, Eddie cheered up. We drank heavily, and we talked openly about many things. I left him at 3:22 in the morning, and he was burbling on quite happily about drug abuse and sexual perversion. When I got here this morning, this is what I found. The mindless violence reminds me of the final paragraph of Eddie's unpublished novel, which he called The Vivisectionist. I feel sick. I don't know where the fuck I am. I think I had too much to drink last night. My life is like a red lion full of drunken Irishmen and gaming machines. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. Give me another scotch, you bastards. Well, Eddie's disappeared. And the only clue that the police had is a photograph taken by an amateur photographer of a raid on a chemist in Chingford this morning at 7:29. Could this be Eddie Monsoon?
And now the end is near and I'm looking at a curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear. State my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I've traveled each and every highway. More than this, I did it my way. Regrets? I've had a few. I can tell you. And now the end is near, and I'm facing. facing the final curtain. Hello, friends, I said, clear, I've stayed my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full.